Hi everyone, and today I'm going to be teaching you how to install and set up Docker. Okay, so this will be the first step to Dockerizing our Django application. So first of all, you want to just type in Docker, and you want to just choose here Docker Home. So the first link here, do not worry, I will include a link in the description below, so don't worry about that. Okay, so what you want to do now is you want to simply go ahead and download Docker Desktop. So as you can see here, we have the various operating systems, Apple, Linux, and so on. So you just want to go ahead and, in my case, it's going to be Windows. So I just am going to say download Docker Desktop for Windows. Okay, so there it is. So it's just busy downloading, so it will be done shortly. So we're just going to wait for that to download, and then we're going to move on to the next set of steps. Okay, so just go ahead and just download Docker Desktop for your operating system, as I mentioned earlier on, and then we'll move on to the next set of steps. Okay, so just wait for that to open up, and there we go. So let's open this up. Okay, so usually when we open this up and start to set up, it does take a while to open up, so don't worry, don't be alarmed, this takes a while. Okay, so your screen will blur, saying a Docker Desktop installer. Just go ahead and say yes. Okay, so you probably won't see this on the screen. Okay, so once you've selected yes, okay, you're going to wait a little bit, and then we should see the Docker Desktop Setup Wizard. Here we go. Right, so it's now installing Docker. Okay, now I just want to warn you guys, this can take a while. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video. So once we've gone there, oh, there we go. Okay, so just go ahead and just select the following. You can choose to add a shortcut if you'd like, as I did. The choice is yours. So I just said yes earlier on. All right, so let's just wait for this to install and set up, which can take some time. So about 10, 15 minutes in some cases. So like I said, I'm going to pause the video and then we'll be straight back to it. Okay, so let's just wait for that. All right. Right. So as we can see, Docker Desktop has successfully been installed. So we can just go ahead and say close. And if we go here, we should now see Docker Desktop on our desktop here. Okay, so this will only show here, okay, if you enable the shortcuts as I did earlier on. If not, you can go ahead and simply just search for it on your computer and just open it up, okay? And to do that, you'll just search for it like Docker Desktop, and then you can just open it like so. All right. So let's go ahead and open this up. Okay. So let's just open that up. So it can take just a few seconds here for this to open. So let's just wait for it. Okay, so there will be something else that we need to do. So that's probably why it's taking just a moment. Ah, there we go. So what we need to do here is we just need to go ahead and accept the Docker subscription service agreement. So basically the important thing here to bear note is Docker Desktop is pretty much free, okay, for all small businesses, fewer than 250 employees and less than $10 million in annual revenue. So I'm sure we all meet that requirement, so we don't need to worry. So we can just go ahead and say accept. So if in the case, okay, you do not, for example, how can I say it? If this doesn't make sense to you, okay, then of course you can actually go ahead and just read more about this just to be aware. Okay, so what you can do now is you can simply go ahead and just accept this here. Okay, so just accept this. Okay, and there we go. So we can now see Docker Desktop on our computer here. Okay, so it's just starting up. So what we can see is we'll be able to then see, once this starts up, our containers, images, volumes, and dev environments, which of course is in the beta stage. So let's just wait for this to start up. So hopefully it starts up soon. Okay, if it's taking too long, what I'll do is I'll pause the video and then we can move on there. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video, and once it's started up, we will carry on. So let's just wait for this. All right. So once it starts up, you'll see this message here. So you don't need to worry about this tutorial. You can just say skip. Okay, so I'm going to teach you everything you need to know, okay, in the next video on Dockerizing with Django. So we can just see here a few settings. So technically, you can go ahead and run a sample container if you'd like, okay, based on Redis, Nginx, or Postgres. Okay, under images, okay, this is basically where all of our Docker images will be. So this is a repository here. Okay, then we also have a space for our volumes. And of course, dev environments. Okay, so technically you can go ahead and create your own environment if you wish, but this is still in the beta stage, so do be aware of that. And the extensions as well. Okay, so the only thing I want you guys to be to focus on are these two sections here. So in the next video, like I said, we're going to Dockerize Django applications. And the process of that basically is that we will make sure that we create a Docker image, or build a Docker image. And we are going to then transform that Docker image, okay, into a Docker container, which we are going to run. Okay, so that's it from me. So this is how you would set up Docker on your desktop. So that's it, guys. Until the next video, thank you so much.